For me, surveillance, we try to understand what is happening at sea. And the sea is very big and we are not there. So it's always a challenge to understand what is going on. So you would like to need all the information you can get. So you can have a ship spotting something, or a manned aircraft, or a drone, or a satellite. And I see it as a toolbox. So I don't want to put things in competition. I'm not saying a manned aircraft is better or worse than a drone or a ship or whatever. They all have their role to play. So it's good to have, let's say, all those possibilities together to make a full maritime picture so that you can find what you're looking for, in this case, migrants. For the drone, it is important. Why is it positive to use drones? It's relatively safe because there are no people on board, so if something goes wrong, you only use loose material, not human life, of course. But also the endurance. So drones can normally fly much longer than a manned aircraft. And the negative side of satellites, satellites are always moving around the Earth.
Yeah.
And you cannot say, I see something interesting, please stop,
and then I lose it.
And you lose it, so you can never stay on the spot. And with a drone, of course, you can also do a routine monitoring, and once you see something very interesting, you just change the command to the drone, and then the drone can stay circling around, let's say, a ship in distress. So let's say we have a request from Frontex to increase the surveillance in Greece or in Italy. So then we will ask one of our contractors that we just have contracted to send a mobile team to Greece, for example, and then it will fly from there. And there will be a complete team, so there will be a technician, an operator, for the payload, for the information, and the pilot. The problem is with drones that most of them, certainly the bigger systems, have been developed for military purposes. And military budgets are a bit different than civil budgets. so that is a bit of an issue that the companies are a bit spoiled by, let's say, the military conditions. Well, of course, the trade-off is different because normally military use drones to go in life-threatening situations. So then you're also willing to pay to save people's lives because you don't want to send people unnecessarily. But of course, for us, the trade-off is different. For us, a drone at the end should be able to compete with manned aircraft. And we're still far away from that point. But I think what is unique also of now this step by EMSA, that it's for the very first time that we bring this drone capacity to the civil world in Europe.